శ్రీమాత్రే నమః. రత్నకింకిణికారమ్య రశనాదామభూషిత. రత్న మీన్స్ జెమ్స్, కింకిణి మీన్స్ ద బెల్స్, రమ్య మీన్స్ బ్యూటిఫుల్. షీ ఈజ్ వేరింగ్ ఎ గర్డల్, ఎ వెయిస్ట్ బ్యాండ్ టు విచ్ ది గోల్డెన్ బెల్స్ స్టడెడ్ విత్ జెమ్స్ ఆర్ హ్యాంగింగ్. రశనాదామభూషిత, షీ ఈజ్ అడోర్న్డ్ by the beautiful sound coming from the ringing of the bells when she is moving. Bhushita means adorned. This waistband is very significant. Even in Upanayanam, they tie a thread made of some specific type of grass, they call maunchi, around the waist. And then only he gets the adhikara of reciting Gayatri Mantram. Of course, the next one is wearing the sacred thread around his shoulders. The female in Hindu Vedic marriages, at the time of marriage also, they tie the same type of thread around the waist of the bride. And then she gets the power of Omkara with that. In Sri Vidya, as you are progressing, you will be listening to 10 types of nadas. Dashavida nadas, they say. The common nadas are Chini nada, Chini Chini nada, వీణానాథ, వేణునాథ, తంత్రీనాథ, డక్కానాథ, ఢమరునాథ, మృదంగనాథ, భేరీనాథ, ప్రాణఘోష, లైక్ దట్ మెనీ నాదాస్ ఆర్ దేర్. అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ 10 టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ నాదాస్ యుల్ బి లిజనింగ్. లిజనింగ్ నాట్ ఫ్రమ్ అవుట్ సైడ్, యాజ్ ఇఫ్ దే ఆర్ కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఇన్సైడ్. ద ఫస్ట్ సౌండ్ ఈస్ ద చినినాదం, రత్న కింకిణికారమ్య రతనాదామ భూషిత. వెన్ ద యాక్చువల్ ఉపాసన స్టార్ట్స్, the universal mother responds with the ringing of the bells or the sound of the bells of the anklets, chininara. You feel that somebody is walking. Many of you must have had this experience. If you had this, kindly share with me, because that's nice to see upasakas having close touch with the mother. So somebody is walking in your house. Don't get scared with that. Mother has put her first step in our house. And then chinchinadam, as if a small girl wearing anklet running around your house, in your house. Then flute. Then the sound of veena, the string instrument. Then as you go forward, then you listen to mridanganadam. Then dakkanadam is announcing the war against our own enemies, our own negative attitude, which is a hurdle to the spiritual progress. Announcing in such a way that without any hesitation, I want to leave all these bad qualities which are coming with me janma after janma. Once you announce, then the actual fight starts by handling the situations. You know, you apply for an examination. Then the actual examination starts. You won't get passed immediately after application. You have to go through the examination. So once you announce that, come whatever it may be, I want to experience mother. And I want to leave all these negative deeds in me, which are standing as a hurdle. So when you go through this examination, you may have to handle different types of situation in our life. And once you are coming out successful, then Bheri Nadam. Bheri is announcement of success. And then Pranaghosha, that is where you listen to your Anahata Shabdam, which is the sound of Prana in you. And that is the final, ultimate sound. After that, you don't need to listen to any sound. All the while, you feel that Omkaram is around you, Omkaram is in the Prakriti. But the same Omkaram, without any syllable, if you experience in the Pranaghosha, that is the ultimate state. So, anybody who meditates on this line, this is 16 letters, Shodasi Nama. All these days we are discussing about Shodasi Nama. Every line what we have discussed is having 16 letters. In Lalita Sahasranamam, it is said that Parameshwari's body, formless entity's form, is divided into three parts. Srimad Vagbhavakoteka Surupa Mukapankaja, Kanthadakata Paryanta Madhyakota Surupani, Shakti Koteka Tapanagatido Bhagadarani. Vagbhavakotam is explained from Champaka Soka Punnaga Saugandhika Lasatkacha, from that line till Anagalita Sadrusya Chubuka Sri Virajita. That is where the Vagbhavakotam ends. And then the Madhyakotam ends at Stanabharadalam Madhya Pattabandha Valitriya. Then the Kamarajakotam, the one below the waist, starts at Ratna Kinkinikaramya Ratanadama Bhukshita and ends at Sinjana Manamanjira Mandita Sri Padambuja. We are actually going through the Panchadashi mantra in a form. Ka'e'i Lakhrim is the Vakbhokutam, Hasakaha Lakhrim is the Majjakutam, Sakalakhrim is the Kamarajam. So that's how the mantras have been, the slokas have been designed. That's why I say Lalita Sahasranam itself is a pack of mantras. It's not a just a line by line. Even if you recite one line, one lady has written to me recently, Guruji, my life has become so easy when you said Lalita Sahasranam can be recited in parts also. Previously, I was thinking that I have to recite the entire Lalita Sahasranam. I didn't find time. Of course, I'm a bit lazy also. I didn't find time to recite. But now you said, what I'm doing is, I'm reciting Lalita Sahasranam in bits and parts. Whenever I get time, whatever line I get, I'm just reciting. Or I'm starting and completing in parts and parts. That's how it is. It has to be. That is why in Phalasruti, it is said, even if you recite one word of Lalita Sahasranam, the power of the recitation, even Shiva cannot explain. So, Ratnakinkinikaramya Rasanadama Bhushita. She is wearing a waistband or waist belt or girdle made of gold to which the golden bells are hanging and the golden bells are studded with gems. And as she is moving, she is creating a divine nadam. Whoever meditates on this nadam is taken through the dashanadas and finally to the ultimate target of listening and experiencing his own pranagosha.
Kamesa jnata saubhagya mardavaru dvayanvita. Kamesa is Ishvara, the one who controls the desire. Jnata, the knower, the one who is understanding. Saubhagya is beauty and auspicious. Mardava is the softness. Uru thais dvaya two. So the combined meaning is Ishvara is the only one who understands and experiences the beauty of the softness of the two thais of Parameshwari. Because Parameshwari is sitting on the lap of Kamesha. In Navavarna Puja, one of the upacharam is Kameshwara Anka Paryanka Upavesanam Kalpayava Namaha. That means Anka Paryanka. She is sitting on Kameshwara. Kameshwara experiences the softness of her thighs. As I always tell, we cannot take the materialistic meaning or the word-to-word meaning of any line in Lalita Sahasranam. Everything has got an inner meaning. So, here when you say Uru, there are two sounds in the beginning and ending of this word. It is a long sound and U is a short sound. U represents the left thigh and U represents the right thigh. And the long sound U is Paravidya and the short sound U is Aparavidya. Paravidya, as you all know, is the knowledge of the absolute, transcendental. Whereas Aparavidya is the knowledge of the world. One is having the reality in its content and it requires no proof. A unique quality of ultimacy that is supreme, free from any reason. The other one, Aparavidya, is a knowledge about the phenomenal world and its content. It's materialistic. And without the support of Paravidya, Aparavidya becomes Avidya. Jiva has to go through both the Vidyas. Kameshwara is the first Srividya Upasaka. That is what, if you list all the Srividya Upasakas, Kameshwara is the first one. And the word Kameshwara itself, Kama is desire and that's Maya. Ishvara is the one who knows about the Maya. Kameshwara. That itself is the Ardhanarishvara Surupam. And because only Kameshwara can know the other part of him, that is the Maya. Ardhanarishvara Surupam, his own part, the other part, only Ishvara can know. That is why Kame Sajnata Saubhagya Bardhavarudvayanvita. Here, even though Maya, we all think, oh, we should come out of the Maya. It says Saubhagya. That is the beauty of the word. Maya is beautiful. Otherwise, there is no drama. See, you want in the movie all the masalas, like thrill, twist and turns. Otherwise, you say, oh, that movie is very, you know, very dull. In the same way, unless there is Maya, there is no interest in the world. If you know all the future, will there be interest? The first Maya comes thinking that you are going to live at least about 70 years, 60 years. You have your own estimate. You estimate your mental health, physical health, and then definitely I'll be living up to 80 years. But the Maya, next moment, we will breathe the last. So that is Maya. The very illusion of living for certain number of years is Maya. And who knows it? The Maya? The Ishvara, who ultimately takes the prana from you. Rodatiti Drudraha. The one who takes prana from the 11 elements, 11 parts of your body, and he makes other people cry. And he is Rudra. Only he knows about this Maya. So that is Kamesa Jnata Saubhagya Mardho Rudvayanvita. Here, the two thighs are described. And the junction of the thigh is Yoni Swarupam. That is the ultimate knowledge. Aim of Sri Vidya is to integrate this Paravidya, which is transcendental, and Aparavidya, which is materialistic. And both these dimensions have to be integrated and experienced. And that is Sri Vidya. And the junction point, the creation, is Yoni Swarupam. So, without this knowledge of Paravidya, Aparavidya becomes Avidya. But the Brahma Vidya is a combination of Vidya, Avidya, Swarupani. Both are supporting this body. Both the left thigh and the right thigh are necessary for the support of the body. For support of the Maya, support of the world, both Paravidya and Aparavidya, both are necessary. And that is Kamesa Jnata Saubhagya Mardavaru Dvyanvita. We can also say one thigh represents differences between male and female and caste and all the things. And other thigh represents Panchabhutas, Manas, Buddhi and subtler. The one is transparent and the other one is subtle. Here, Kameshwara is the one who conquers the desire. The one who controls the desire. The one who masters the desire. Becomes a master, Paramahamsa. He only can know the beauty of Maya. He doesn't hate difficulties. He just goes with the life. And that is experiencing the beauty of Maya. Jagannataka Sutradhari, that is what Annamaya and Ramadasa hail Rama. Jagannataka Sutradhari. They know that everything is being done by the will of the Parabrahma. And that experiencing that is Kamesa Jnata Saubhagya Mardo Rudvayanvita. Sri Matre Namaha.